What's up, everyone? It's Chicks in the Office with Rianne Fran, giving that Friday energy on a Monday. Hopefully everyone had a beautiful weekend, and hopefully you're bundled up, ladies and gentlemen, because shit is getting cold out there, and I know that I'm bundled up. How about you guys?
You feeling really cold this morning?
Yeah, 40 degrees.
Yeah, it was cold.
I broke up my new jacket.
So did I.
Is that it?
It is, yeah.
Wow, very congratulations.
Nice. Thanks.
Very nice.
My
jacket.
Mic just wasn't on for that when I said that, but yeah, I broke out my new jacket.
You broke out your jacket.
Do you buy your own clothes?
Yeah.
Very
well,
nice.
Who else would?
No, I don't know if like your mom buys you clothes.
Still? She like ships them to my apartment?
Damn.
Not in a mean way, just like maybe.
Oh yeah, is that like a shot at what I'm wearing?
No, not at all.
I thought it was like
I was about
like
to compliment the way you dress.
Oh, thanks. No, no, I buy my own
clothes. You're not, like he still has his mommy buy his clothes for him.
No, not like that at all. I was about to compliment the way you dress. I think that you're a well put together guy. Some people are not well put together at all. I think you are, and so I just was curious if you did all your own shopping.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Very nice.
You have cool pieces, but like I wouldn't say it's that crazy what he wears sometimes.
Did I call them crazy?
Yeah.
I didn't call them crazy.
Put together just sound like
I said. Put together.
Well,
you wear like sweatpants to work every day.
Yeah, but in a cool way.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
They are cool pieces, yes.
Yeah.
I couldn't just give the man a compliment.
No, I just...
Well, you don't dress well.
Compared
no,
to how
together,
the...
No, put together.
He's put together. He's clean.
It's all relative.
Hygienic.
Yeah.
Like,
okay.
Like,
well, yeah.
You see some...
I hope so.
No, but I'm saying you see some people.
Yes.
And you're like, they're not put together at all. Noah is put together.
I was thinking of put together in a different way.
I mean, you could say
put together
wearing a suit, but that's not
like nicer, dressier outfits.
I don't know.
Yeah.
No.
These are new sneakers, too.
Yeah, like you got new sneakers
on, cool sneakers.
Your joggers, like I just feel like you match your shoes and your hat and your
I'm
shirt.
I'm good with color coordination.
Yes, like
you color coordinate.
He does like a...
Sue me, I was trying to give you a compliment.
Like, I know what colors work with other colors, and why would I not... Why would I wear colors that look terrible together?
Listen, I was just giving you a compliment, and some people just... You see some people walking around here, and you're like, how the fuck did they put those two pieces together and walk in this place?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
That is, I think, an openly talked about thing.
I think, yeah, a lot of people here.
And I don't think people would be offended. I think people are aware that they do that.
No.
Remember, we did that whole when we had Because We Got High, we brought in a bunch of people.
We brought in a bunch of guys.
Just how they looked.
And, right, and how they dress. Which is.
And everyone who got good reviews.
I can't really
remember.
I know Devin, they made fun of Devin for a while.
Yeah, but I get it, though. You're like, if you're just sitting at your desk all day long, you're just throwing things together.
Oh,
so.
That's like my philosophy is like, who am I trying to impress? Like,
right, but I
do like to just look cool if I can.
Put together.
Yeah, I'll say cool.
Yeah, cool. All right. Well, you
Very
know what?
Cool.
I was just trying to compliment you, and
Thank
I felt
you.
Like it backfired on me.
No,
it backfired on me.
No.
I took a ricochet
absolutely,
shot.
Absolutely, you were absolutely complimenting him.
You got a nice jacket right here.
I think I've put together.
You haven't seen me, but you want me to put my jacket on for you? Because that really ties this whole outfit together.
The jacket matches the shoes.
Yeah.
And
you don't have to put it on. I believe you. I can see the colors in my face. Is that a Carhartt jacket?
No.
Oh, no. Looks for everyone listening, Noah is now putting on his jacket.
It
and
looks
yes,
like one.
The jacket, the shoes, it all matches.
Yeah. I like this jacket. It's kind of bigger.
Okay. So I meant color coordinated.
Yeah, my shoes.
Yeah.
Hair.
Yeah. Yep.
Where's the jacket from?
It's J.W. Anderson.
J.W. Anderson.
Collab with Uniqlo, which is also my other jacket. So
nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
Uniqlo is great for basics.
I'm wearing a.
That's another like back in the compliment.
No. That is not at all. I mean,
I think
basics.
She meant basics.
Oh, yeah,
I meant
like,
basics as like t-shirts.
She didn't mean like your basic.
No, I meant like basic items.
I'm wearing a
Buda
Ben.
Oh, I love those shirts and Buda Ben. Shout out Buda Ben.
There you go.
Yes, I meant it more of. I meant basics like you get your t-shirts and you're like your.
Don't worry, I'm never gonna compliment
simple,
Noah again.
They have good shirts.
Well, this started because you asked him if his mom still bought his
clothes. But it wasn't in a mean way. I was just wondering like if she like sent like
I wanna,
you go home and she's like, oh, I picked these up. You know what I mean? I don't know.
Yeah.
Sometimes moms do that.
No, I don't really dress similarly to anyone else in my family, I would say. Yeah, my brother's like way more preppy.
Mm.
Yeah.
Vineyard Vines kind of guy?
Yeah. Like Sperry's,
Oh, Ugh. Gosh.
Nobody's wearing Sperry's.
Not my
No, I mean, he doesn't wear Sperry's anymore. He did at one point. Now.
Yeah. I was going to say, he's not wearing Sperry's now.
No, he's not, but.
He's that's the, like, next, that's the like, next new thing that Sperry's.
Yeah, whatever it is. Like.
He's wearing.
Well, honestly, he's like transitioning into like more skater now, which I'm like, what the fuck?
He's figuring it out. Roasting your brother.
Yeah.
Let's just get the whole Ives family in here and go one by one on how they dress. I bet your mom dresses fantastic.
My I don't, yeah. I don't,
and your grandma.
She definitely
does. Oh, my grandma does.
She definitely does.
But yeah. My dad gets roasted by, like, people because he'll wear, like, flip-flops and socks out to, like, dinner.
Oh.
Can't be having that.
Yeah.
No.
You cannot be having that, no.
That's not put together.
Yeah. Well. No, it's a tough. No.
Anyways, cool new jacket. I'm happy you got it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Fran, how was your weekend? How was
Fantastic.
Vegas?
Fantastic. It was great.
Okay, well, I want to go on a scale for you to ask you to rate things.
Okay.
First, I want to start with Vegas as a whole. Take away the Jonas Brothers. Just Vegas.
Oh, not
out
my
of
place.
10. Out of 10.
Not
really?
My place. I mean, no.
I guess that's not surprising.
Rate it out of 10.
I mean, in the defense of Vegas, I really, most of my activities were Jonas Brothers oriented, so like I wasn't really doing anything. I did have some very nice meals, but I didn't really do.
Did you gamble?
A little bit, but not.
Where'd you
crazy.
Go? Casinos.
I walked through like all of them.
Oh really?
Yeah, because I wanted to see the
Caesar's Palace.
See it all. Yeah, went through the Bellagio, went through Caesar's Palace.
Those are two big
ones. MGM. Did you see the fountains at Bellagio?
Yeah.
You see them go off?
I had a nice moment where I was standing on the walkway at the Bellagio and the water was going off and Viva Las Vegas was playing on the speaker.
Oh, that's beautiful. Was, Were you like, Viva? Did you sing along
Viva
to it?
Viva Las Vegas. It was Elvis. It was
Did
great.
You see a lot of Elvis impersonators?
No, honestly, no.
Because I feel like that's like kind of...
like the Times Square, like people in cartoons.
After
costumes.
Austin Butler, everyone's like, yeah. we can't
pull We got to retire.
Yeah.
We got to put our good. Put down the uniform.
Yeah, it was first of all, super cold in Vegas. Like,
really?
What's
really
super
cold
in Vegas? Like,
It was
70 here.
Like 45 degrees
what?
When we woke up in the morning. Yeah.
Like all day?
Yeah.
That's
How?
Insane.
Like the high was like, it's a desert. It's cold in the winter there. It was like 60 degrees high at like
so 3
p.m.
Here.
Yes, it was hotter here.
It was hotter here. It was like 70 degrees on Saturday.
It was cold. It was actually very cold.
It was
cold.
Too hot, what am I saying?
Vegas is like a... I don't know. I would go again. Like I would give it another
shot.
Would
you
shot
go like
with friends?
Bachelorette party? Like woo!
I would
not your own.
I would never have my own. And I hope not. Honestly,
what about mine?
I hope my friends don't do it. You would want to go to Vegas.
She definitely would want to go to Vegas.
No, I'm not dying to go to Vegas. Probably more Miami.
I'd rather go somewhere like tropical.
Miami or honestly a tropical vacation.
Yeah.
Like we get like a sick house somewhere in
yeah.
a tropical. Location.
I mean, I guess maybe I would like to do it once to say I've done it.
Yeah, well, I was supposed to go for my sister's bachelor. You were coming.
We were going
to,
yes. That would have been my, like,
that
would have
been,
like, check.
Honestly, though, that would have been really fun. We had a lot of fun things planned, but then
yeah.
COVID hit. It was literally the same exact weekend that everything shut down, so we couldn't go for my
yeah.
sister's bachelorette party.
Yeah.
That would have been.
I had my flights.
Yeah, we
everything.
Had everything.
We
were going.
Go.
We were going to Vegas, me and you,
yeah.
babes. But that
it's
didn't
like
happen.
It's like a 6 point.
Don't be afraid to go.
What would you rate Atlantic City?
I haven't spent enough time in Atlantic City.
I mean,
like,
you spent like the same
amount. I mean,
amount.
You can't compare Vegas and Atlantic City.
No, but I mean, you can compare. I mean, they're so similar.
They're not, though.
I haven't spent just, time
they're,
at
the,
it, no,
just because
so
they're
not.
Hotel and casinos, like the
no,
Las
I, no.
Vegas Strip.
I haven't.
I mean, it's 100 times better.
Yeah, Atlantic City Boardwalk used to be something. No longer.
Yeah, and also, like, the only time I've spent in Atlantic City as an adult, a legal drinking age adult, was when we went and we were there for one night.
And we stayed in the presidential suite, which doesn't
like
happen.
Very nice. And yeah. we also didn't like leave the hotel.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Which Vegas, I still like walked around and was outside and did stuff. I didn't, all I dabbled in was like digital blackjack. I didn't.
Digital?
I was too scared to sit at the
table. Sit at the table, I know what you mean. It is intimidating.
I was scared. I'm like, I've never done it before. So I was like, I'm gonna be in bed, like,
and in
with
Vegas,
the chips. Like,
they
I don't want to. Yeah,
very
go to the
serious.
Cheapest
exactly.
table. That's what I did. Like,
yeah. Well, that's what you could do digitally and just sit
no,
on
know.
Your own.
But you
yeah.
don't get the same rush.
As
like a real person sitting with other
yeah.
people.
I made $70, cashed out.
Love it.
I was like, put $100 in, went to 170, said, I'm good.
I don't think any of your friends would have their bachelorette parties in Vegas. No, I think Nashville. I could sense a lot of Nashville.
Maybe. I don't even know.
Where would
Nashville.
You want yours?
Italy.
I don't even know if I like really want a big thing.
Yeah,
really.
Rhea, yeah. She was talking to me. She's not sure that you're going to make the cut.
I'm sure. I wouldn't be surprised if I got left off the list.
No, I just like, I don't know. I just feel like I wouldn't have a hard time deciding on a place, or I would just do like a fun New York like weekend vibe.
Just get, like, stay in New York?
Get like a big spot, like a hotel or like a suite in New York. Like,
all right, that's have interesting. Have a weekend. And I'm not one that like, I don't know why we're talking about Bachelor and Bachelor. Like, I'm not like, oh, last hurrah with my ladies. Like, yeah, I don't agree with that. It's like, no, you've been dating. Like, it's not like, oh my God, it's our one last night. Like, no, you can keep going out. It's just more about like the excuse to like go on a fun trip.
Yeah. I'm like, by the time it's me.
Like, I'd love to just sit on an island for a couple of days.
Totally. I don't know. I get worried about like, and I think it's just because now I'm on the other side of it where people are worried about taking time off work and how expensive the trips are and all these things that I feel like by the time mine comes around, I'm going to be like worried about making people spend money. And I don't want
I'm not worried about anyone
crazy.
Else other than myself.
Yeah, we know.
No, I'm just saying like in this scenario.
Yeah.
What's your dream bachelor party?
It's a good question. I mean, I haven't thought about it. Like,
I feel like it's something more like
I would love to just
skiing
like
skiing or something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, or like going to a concert and like with a bunch of people.
Yeah,
and,
like
you
chill.
Know,
Yeah.
I'm not.
I'm
a big,
down
like,
with that.
Club guy.
Right. So. Like when guys are like I gotta hit the clubs. It's like all right. Yeah. Like for what?
Yeah.
But I get it. But I also don't.
Yeah.
You so, know, it's so like a little bit of both.
I just Vegas. You know what? I didn't. I feel like maybe it's because of the weather. Like people do it more in the warmer months. I didn't really see a lot of bachelor or bachelorettes walking around. Saw a lot of birthdays, people. I'm like, it's my birthday. Mm-hmm. And honestly, a lot of like international folks, a lot of accents.
Yeah.
But not a lot of like, ooh, bachelorette.
Yeah, because they're taking their place in Nashville now.
Yeah.
That's all I saw.
Or this time of year, maybe like, they're in like Tulum, you know.
Right,
going
right. Going somewhere
going
warm.
Going somewhere warm. All right. I'm like, I'm telling you, it was cold.
So how was the brothers?
Oh, they were, the brothers were great. Couldn't have been better. They're all doing this like long hair thing right now.
They're looking good.
They are looking real good.
I responded to your story.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you were saying, Free responded to my story of Joe and he had like a black trucker hat on and his hair was like long and like kind of like wet looking, I would say. Not wet
curly.
Looking, but like curly, but it had product in mm-hmm. it. So it wasn't, so it had, and she was like, I like this look. I was like, yeah, because he fucking looks like Marty. Like,
oh my God.
I'm like, that's
I like my man.
I'm like, that's
I don't know.
I was like, that's Marty's look.
Looks good.
No, they all look great. They, Thursday night, we had pit tickets, which was awesome. And then Friday, our plan was just to kind of like last minute go to the box office and see what they had. Because we knew, kept checking Ticketmaster. We knew there were seats available. And so we went Friday morning and got seats that were objectively very funny. This layout of the Dolby Live, which when the lights are on, looks like a really nice high school auditorium. Like it's like
it's small.
It's really small.
How many people total?
I don't know, maybe like 5,000.
Oh, we could sell it out.
We could do a collab with the Joe Bros.
Oh no, 6,400.
Oh,
so it's a good number. And they had 5,200 seats, it says. And then there was like seats on the floor, pit. And then it was like pit. There was a section on the floor of all seats. And then there was like a big gap, you know, like just an alleyway, whatever you want to call it, where you go walk to your seats. And then it went up to the seats, second 100. There was 200, 300, 400. And the 200, the bottom of the 200 were the VIP tables. And that's where all the like family and friends were sitting. And our seats Friday night were on the floor, but they were up against the wall of the tables. Mm. So it was like there was a gap from where I'm sitting right now to like even farther from where Noah is to where the next group of seats were. So we just kind of had like
a lot of space.
And it was funny because when people were coming in and out, it was like we were like the welcoming committee. Like people were coming in, we're like, hey, like Claire and me.
Well-known people?
Yeah. Thursday, Sophie was there. She wasn't, I don't know, maybe she was, but didn't go to the shows. Thursday, she went to the shows, to the show. Friday, Saturday, Priyanka was there. Then, of course, like their parents were there for all three shows. So when they were coming in and out, Friday, they were standing in front of us. There was also one of the guys from Claim to Fame, who I think he won Claim to Fame. I'm not positive on that, but I'm pretty sure he won. This kid, Logan, he's Jason Aldean's cousin. And he like also wants to be a country singer. He's a cute guy. He was there and people were losing their shit.
Really?
Yeah, we like they cracking knew him? Me up. Yeah, because Kevin and Frankie host the show. So yeah, like true. People were like, oh my God, Logan. And
Frankie was there.
He was walking. Unless I didn't see him. I did not see him. A lot of friends. I think a lot of the people that worked on their new album. But Thursday we went to Nelly's, which is their Papa Jonas's restaurant. They have one open in the MGM. That was delightful. Villa One cocktails. Had the time of our lives.
What did you eat? What was the meal?
Thursday was a weird eating day because we were traveling. But I did, because as soon as we got there, we like had lunch and then we got drinks. What did we get? We got like a pimento cheese dip and we got, fried green tomatoes. Oh, so good. So it's a Nelly Southern Kitchen. It's like they have one in North Carolina and they open one in Vegas. So it's all like Southern comfort food, biscuits and gravy, that kind of thing.
I like biscuits and gravy.
Really, really very, very good. And Friday we went out. Friday and Saturday we went to like a nicer dinner before both shows. But Friday night, Claire and I were sitting in these seats and the show that they put on was maybe number one, 100% top three Jonas show I've ever been to.
Really? Like you've been to a lot.
I've been to a lot. And it was, the energy was just
incredible.
Have you been
to over 20?
I
feel like we went to five that one year.
I've been to like five.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Claire and I have kind of gone through it. Our guesstimate is somewhere in the low 20s now, probably.
Mm-hmm. You just went to three.
Yeah, exactly. Just did three. Mm-hmm. But this one was like the energy was insane. I've never seen Nick on stage like that ever. Like he was just, I don't know if he was just drinking a little bit or like, I don't know what. He was just high energy. He was just a smiley, joking guy. And the energy was phenomenal. The crowd was great. They brought their dad on stage Friday and Saturday, but on Friday night they sang Rocket Man all together. And it was just, moved me to tears.
That sounds beautiful.
It was beautiful. His voice is insane.
I saw some video you reshared on your Nick story Jonas? Of like when he was on stage. Papa.
Their dad.
Their dad's voice?
Their dad. Did you listen to my videos?
No, I watched them without sound.
Unbelievable.
I'm pretty sure Fran also said like sound on or something.
Yes, because
Was that on your story or in the group chat?
No, it was on my story.
On your story. I don't watch anyone's stories with the sound on. I'm sorry.
That's fine. He is incredible.
Clips. Yeah.
I mean, now I want to play it so you can hear it. Like, it's like.
I'm picturing like opera.
Right, but what if I had a bad reaction?
You're not going to.
It feels fake now, but I'll listen.
You're not going to, I promise. This was from. Let me find the one. Fast forward it a little bit. Hold on.
A lot of pressure.
You should buy a new phone just to have storage for Jonas Brothers content. You were still blown away. You dropped your phone.
I did. They sounded, and then wait. This was the one towards the end. Wait, here, listen to him.
Oh, Desperado.
Yeah.
Nice.
He's good.
It's like.
Well, they got to get their voice from somebody.
Where's Mama Jonas when this is happening?
Like, he's got.
That must
like,
be like a dream God. For him to get up there and just fucking belt it.
Yeah, I mean, and they've never, they've have not, that's the first time they've ever done that. Bring him on stage and all sing together.
Jonas Brothers and Father.
Yeah.
He was incredible. She was there. She's in the crowd.
No, I know. I'm sure that was an emotional moment for him.
Friday, he, on his way to his seats, because I was just. Directly, we were directly in their faces. Claire and I were like, hey, like just like waving at people. And he stopped and gave me a big hug. I've never met him.
And there was recognition.
There was 100% recognition.
So let's start there.
So Papa Jonas knew.
There was recognition. He was like, oh, like I don't know if he like knew exactly who I was, but there was like a facial recognition where he was like, ah, like I think I know you. Gave me a hug. It was very nice. I tagged him in some stories. He responded and was resharing them. He was very funny. I was like, it was so incredible. And he was just like, ha. Huh? Like, after I posted Saturday too, he was like, you're so funny. Thank you.
You're so funny. You went to every show.
Papa Jonas was the first one when you guys first made that video when the Jonas Brothers came back that like shared it.
Yeah. Him and
yeah, and Denise.
Yeah. So
it was great. And Friday was so amazing that we changed all of our plans to stay for Saturday. Moved my flight to a red eye, stayed the day.
That's insane.
Yeah. Shout out Game Time. They made it happen. And I know everybody was asking. I did go to the signing on Friday. It was interesting because we just maneuvered it well. There was two of them. He did two liquor stores with John Varvatos, which I would love to talk to him because it must just be a funny experience for him because everyone like is losing their shit and then he's just kind of like, yeah, also my tequila as well.
Yep.
And the first stop, Claire and I were together and then our friend Alana and her boyfriend were together. And we're staying in different places. So
first stop, you went to both liquor stores?
No.
Okay.
We were separate. They went to the first one because their day had just started earlier. And they were like, there's kind of a lot of people here already. So we were like, Claire and I were like, let's try the second one. Mm-hmm. So we went to the second one, kind of assessed the scene. There's probably 50-ish or so people in line. We were like,
there were more.
This is the one we stay in. So we got in line there.
How humble was everyone in line?
Couldn't have been nicer. Good group of people.
They're like, we'll wait here all day. No rush, Nick.
Please, I mean, take your time.
There were people lined up early. We waited. The first signing, there was like 600 people that showed up. And so they cut it off after a certain point. So my friend and her boyfriend didn't even make it into the liquor store.
Ooh.
And
cold.
It's just like, you can't have that many people. It's supposed to be, he was only supposed to be at each spot for an hour. So it's like.
Yeah, too many.
600 people in an hour, not going to happen. When he got to ours, it was just funny, like security and liquor store owners. They're like, 10 seconds, people. You got 10 seconds in and out. Like, we're moving. He was like rapidly signing bottles and then like you would grab the bottle as you walked out. And Claire and I were maybe one of like the last few people I think they even let into the store. We got in the group and we get closer in the line. The group in front of me stops. Nick kind of looks at the line, totally like double takes. And I'm like, ah, shit. I was like, I knew this. Like, not I knew it was coming, but I was like, I was so nervous. I was like, what am I going to say? It's only 10 seconds. Like, I don't have my spiel of, like, I was like, in my head, I was like, if he doesn't realize, and then I have to do my spiel of, like, like, the whole thing, and they're going to rush me out of there. That's embarrassing, the whole thing. So I got, when I start to walk up, he looks at me and he goes, oh, hey. Like, he kind of like,
it's like, what the fuck are you
like,
doing
he,
here?
Like, totally just like looked at me and went, oh, hey, you. Like, oh, hey, you.
Hey, you. Look at us.
He didn't add that. He didn't add the you, but he said, oh, hey. Like, hey. So I was like,
funny
hey.
Seeing you here.
I was like, hey.
I just happened to be in Vegas.
Yeah, I was like, what? I believe what I said was, because now it's just a blur. I believe I was like, yeah, you know, got a rep Chicks in the Office in Vegas. And he was like, obviously, you going to the show tonight? I said, yeah, like we went last night. It was so much fun. And he was like, oh, you know, tonight's going to be even more fun, like in his like little Nick voice.
Yeah.
And that was it. And they ushered me
and
along.
They dragged her out of there.
A hug.
And he did give me a hug, which threw me off.
Don't forget that.
And he wasn't giving hugs?
From what I saw, there was a lot of handshakes happening. And so when I walked up, I was mentally prepared for a handshake, and it was a hug.
And he put his arms up.
I don't know if it was, I hope it was a good hug on his
end. Did he hug Claire?
I don't think so.
Ooh. Ooh.
Wow. Question for you.
I have to.
And you could tell me that this is a bad question. You could tell me to shut up, but it's a question. Is there any part of you when you're sitting on the plane, right, and you're going to Vegas and you're so excited and whatever, and you're thinking about the signing, you're going to see Nick, is there any part of you in your head that goes, maybe one day when he sees me, he'll just drop it all and go, we're meant to be together?
No. I knew you were going to
say. I knew that's what she was going to say too. No longer.
No longer?
I've moved on with that.
I'm just curious because as a
15-year-old girl, yes, that was my thought process.
He's a father.
It was just a
question.
No, when I was like 15 and like chasing after him in the Short Hills Mall, when people were like, oh, the Jonas Brothers are at the mall, like those kinds of things. Yeah, 100%. It was like, oh my God, he's going to see me and we're going to take a picture.
And he's going to be like, wait a second. Like, you need to stay because I just love you
100%.
So much.
But now he knows you and it hasn't happened.
Now that is gone in my mind.
Okay.
My
know.
Thought process more on the plane was like, I just hope I don't embarrass myself. And
many people though that like even if you did something embarrassing, it wouldn't even really be embarrassing.
No. And he was very nice, and I'm glad I went, and I have the tequila bottle now at home to
that's beautiful
commemorative moment.
Well, I'm glad
there
you had a great time.
There's a selfie. The pictures are so uncomfortable though when they set up the meet and greets or not. It's not even a meet and greet. So many people showed up for both places. They had a setup like for a professional photo and a backdrop, but I think so many people were there that they were like, that's going to take way too long. Everyone can take a selfie and move on. But they were like standing behind a table. So you're kind of like, holding your phone, you're like leaning. They're leaning over a table. You're leaning over a table.
Wait, what's
you're
the other guy's
just
name?
Like John Varvatos.
You should have been like, hey, can you mind getting out of the shot?
I think like I saw on Twitter. I mean, I saw people's photos on Twitter of their selfies, and they totally could have just like zoomed and cropped him out. But there were a lot that didn't have him in it, and I was like, damn, that's ruthless.
I mean, I would have asked him to move.
I would not have asked him to move.
Maybe not, but I would definitely crop him out.
If I was him, I wouldn't.
I shook his hand. I said, hey, John, how are you?
Let's be honest. We're here for Nick.
If I was him, I would remove myself from the picture.
Yeah,
but
I mean,
I would never
like, you wouldn't have this
I would
line
never ask
Nick.
Him to be removed from the picture. But if I was him, I would remove myself.
Yeah, and God forbid.
Like, I would
like,
be like, just take your, you take your picture.
And
I'd
feel like that, you know, Nick's right there. You don't want to be rude to his business partner.
Oh, no, no.
You just frame it up in a way that's like.
So it's a little selfie of the three of us.
I also don't see the bad in having him in it. Like Nick Jonas is still in the picture.
Exactly. And it's a Villa One signing.
So when did you come? When did you come home?
I'm
so confused.
I took a red eye after the show on Saturday.
Well, so you went from the show to the airport?
Yep. Where was your luggage?
They were keeping it at the front desk.
What time?
Our flight was originally at midnight. It got delayed. We knew like at like 4 p.m. it got delayed.
So you're kind of relieved, I bet.
So we knew we had time. Like, we hung out after the show. That's when I won my $70.
Yeah.
Got some food.
Mm-hmm.
And then the plus side of Vegas is the airport's, like, 8 minutes away. Like, it's very close. So when it got to be, like, 11:45, hopped on, got in an Uber, headed to the airport. Claire had to leave. Unfortunately, she couldn't stay for Saturday because, I mean, she was... I don't know how she did this, but she was on a concert extravaganza. She went to LA for Harry Styles.
What?
Yeah.
After? Oh, yeah. I think you said that.
Which she had planned already. Okay. Like, she had those plans.
Well, Vegas
set.
To LA isn't that crazy.
No, it's not crazy. And so myself and Alana and her boyfriend, we were like, we're staying. So we...
I was going to say, did you go alone?
Wait, so her boyfriend went to 3 Jonas Brothers concerts in a row?
Yeah.
That's dedication.
He's a good boyfriend. And he does like the Jonas Brothers. Like, he is a
They put
fan
on a great show. It's not like
they
a bad...
Saturday night, guys, this man and his wife are sitting next to us. They're very nice, very chatty. They don't know, like, anything about them. I think the wife had watched the documentary and was like, oh, my God, these, you know, they're so cute. And I think they may have lived in Vegas. So, like, they're doing a Vegas show. Mm-hmm. We should go. And... they were having the time of their lives, but the guy next to me was cracking me up because he kept leaning over to me and being like, okay, Nick, Joe kept like trying to like point them all out because they were moving around stage. Then about halfway through, he's just like, he's screaming, I love Nick. I'm cracking up. He's like,
he got the fever.
Oh my God. He's like, there are some good looking guys. There's some good, and they're like, they're talented. They're good. And I'm like, I told you, because at the beginning I was like, get ready. And I would say, like, by the end, they were like, he goes, that was a great show. Those guys are great.
Isn't it like amazing how the Jonas Brothers and Justin Bieber, like, they grew up to be what everyone wanted them to be, basically. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Like, you were, like, people were obsessed with these guys, and they could have grown up and, like, went severely downhill, but they just grew up and went uphill. Yeah.
Harry
like,
Styles, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, they just kept getting better and better.
Yeah. And good life choices. Like, they've married amazing people, and seems like they're, like, going about life in a good way. They've been teasing this new album that we have been hearing about for quite some time. It's done, apparently. They've said it multiple times. Kevin was like, you're going to be seeing a lot of us next year. So I'm hoping they go back on tour.
I'm assuming.
New album, new sound. Nick was saying it's his favorite yet. Can't wait.
Ooh, a Nick favorite.
I hope it's sooner rather than later. I'm hoping like
you're not
early
a Nick,
next year.
Nick girl, I thought, right?
I'm a just all. I don't have a specific one.
It's always. I mean, not that I have one, but it would be Joe. I feel like he's just the coolest one.
Super fair.
Yeah, I don't have a specific one. I like them all.
They all sounded amazing. Their dynamic is very funny. Every night they like. Every night, even when they do regular shows, like the crowd does a Kevin chant. And Joe and Nick are always like, all right, get it over with, Kevin.
Well, because they know that the rest of the show, everyone's screaming for Nick and Joe.
He has his moments. Kevin looked very good. Like, I loved his outfits every night. He also was doing this long hair situation.
What is this? Like, they're the Beatles?
Yeah, they're bringing the curls back, which is a throwback to, like, 2008. They all had really long curly hair, which I think it is amazing. So very happy.
10 out of 10 weekend?
Phenomenal weekend. Just couldn't have been happier with my life choices.
That's amazing.
And I'll be honest, I know I don't sound amazing, but I feel like I could have sounded worse today.
You could have, for sure.
I could have sounded
worse. You
went
to 3 concerts in a row.
Yeah. And it was Saturday. I tried to Like, there were moments where I was, like, just mouthing the words. And then there was times that just, you just can't hold back, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Three nights they did, like, medleys of old albums. Thursday they did a little bit longer. Friday they did Jonas Brothers, self-titled. And Saturday they did Lines, Vines, and Trying Times, which they never sing songs from that album. And I lost my shit. I couldn't believe they were singing. Like, I was like, I don't know if I'll ever see them perform What Did I Do to Your Heart live ever again. I think they'll keep doing Vegas shows, which I'll probably continue to go back to.
That.
And I assume they'll do that kind of format, because that format for a show I thought was like the best format they've done when they don't have new music. It's like, you're not touring for Happiness Begins, so you don't have to do all the songs. It was a good setup. But there's like World War III, Hey Baby, like songs. I was like, I cannot believe they are doing these songs. And I was sad because Claire said that to Nick at the signing on Friday. She was like, Lines, Vines, I'm here to tell you, Lines, Vines, Trying Times. Like, come on, you got to do some songs. And then they did it Saturday. But
aww.
Yeah, it was good though.
I'm glad you got the full experience.
I think I did.
I was just picturing them doing like what Elvis did as Vegas residency, where he just goes into the crowd and makes out with everyone.
Yeah.
They all go in.
The times have changed.
Yeah.
Times have changed.
I don't think
on
they
that
ever
one.
Did that, but.
But it was great. Great crowd. A lot of fun. It was a good experience.
That sounds amazing.
All in all,
and in the end, Rhea and I were right.
Yeah.
About Nick.
Yeah. I mean, I will definitely say, like, you guys were right. My only point is that I was not arguing that he wouldn't recognize me. My argument was I don't want to go in with the expectations.
Being superstitious.
Yeah, exactly. I just didn't want to expect it and then be disappointed.
Yep.
So, yes, you were right in thinking that there would be some facial recognition.
Humble fan, noble man, Nick
Jonas. I did get a lot of very nice girls that were throwing.
Humble fan.
The humble fan. Yeah. They were like, Fran, just a lot of humble fans.
Just look at us, humble fans.
I was like, yeah.
Standing online.
That's all of us waiting online, buying merch, yeah. Getting drinks,
what's
the whole thing.
Opposite of humble in the dictionary? Is there? Cocky?
Pompous?
That's a good word.
Thank you.
Opposite of humble. Technically, this says like a... proud and overbearing, noble.
Oh, those are like good words.
Oh, no. Antonyms for humble. Arrogant.
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 I'm going to start the arrogant fan club for John Mayer.
John Mayer.
Pompous.
Wow.
Conceited. Presumptuous. Egotistical.
Egotistical.
Superior.
Fan.
Supercilious.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you had an amazing weekend.
It was. It was a phenomenal weekend.
No point in talking about ours because I got nothing to add to that. Yeah. That's an extravaganza.
Did you do anything fun?
I went out on Saturday all day. And yeah, I'm
crazy.
I'm so crazy. I am not I love drinking at night. I don't love drinking during the day.
I am kind of opposite.
Just like when the hangover, when the hangover hits at night, it's fucking brutal.
Yeah, that's
like,
true.
When you're sobering up and it's like 9, 10 o'clock and you're sobering up and you start getting a headache.
You just have to keep drinking.
And you're like, right.
Either keep
but if
drinking
you're not,
or just like go to bed.
Because I feel like I never get hungover after drinking during the day.
I literally went to sleep at 9:30 Saturday night because I was out from 2 o'clock to 8 o'clock and then went home and I was like, my head hurts so fucking bad. I just gotta go to sleep. Like, I would rather go out all night and wake up in the morning feeling shitty.
Yeah.
And then deal with the hangover all day than be hungover at night. I don't know why. That sounds crazy because I feel like most people would disagree with that. It's just something about it. But I had a great weekend.
I slept so much yesterday. Like, so much.
Really?
Like, till... like
catching up
3 p.m. woke
as
up
as did I
like was up, went to see a movie, the one with Colin Farrell, what's it called, like, you know it,
don't know,
Banshee Irish something, like,
don't know it,
very good. Then came back, took another nap like at 8
sleepy.
p.m. woke up,
wow,
stayed up for a few more hours and went back to bed.
White Lotus was bad. Bad. Last night, bad.
Ooh.
Just bad. Like,
yeah.
Severely lacking.
Bless you.
Just
thank you.
An awful episode.
I'm happy for all the Yellowstone fans.
Oh yeah, big Yellowstone night.
I don't watch Paramount.
I don't watch either. I don't watch it either, but maybe we need to start.
Everyone was so excited about it. I'm just happy for them that they were so excited.
It was on Netflix at one point. I know that. And then I went to Netflix and it's not there.
Yeah, I don't know. It's on Paramount now.
If
but
it was ever on Netflix?
No, I think it was.
Oh, maybe they moved it when Paramount Plus became a thing.
I don't know, but I know that people were really excited about that, and I wish I was.
Is it a weekly show?
I think now it's back.
Yeah, it is.
But like, it's like, not like all at once.
Yeah.
Paramount Plus. I think it used to be on Paramount Channel.
Where does Paramount Channel even exist?
Or maybe not.
Yeah, maybe. I wanted to start
watching. The show airs on Paramount Network, not to be confused with their streaming service, Paramount Plus. Because Yellowstone signed a deal with the NBC-owned Peacock prior to creating its own streaming platform, it won't be on Paramount Plus. Oh. So, the show's always been on Paramount Network. But I guess they agreed to be on, you can rewatch on Peacock, the new episodes on Peacock. Mm-hmm. Not on Paramount Plus.
Yeah, I don't know.
That is, that's extremely confusing.
Confusing, but I might get on it because people are obsessed with that show. I remember I watched the first one or two episodes and I enjoyed it, and then I don't know why I didn't continue watching. But I might get on that because White Lotus week to week is just not doing it.
Yeah.
I'm excited. There's only 3 episodes left, I think, and I can't wait for the season to be over.
How many seasons of Yellowstone are there?
I think this might be the 3rd or 4th season, but I could be wrong.
Season 5.
Oh, shit. Oh, see, that's too many.
I know, that's like, we've reached the point where that's hard to catch up.
Like, if there were 2 seasons out, I could do it. But now, 4 seasons out?
Yeah.
How the fuck am I going to do that? That's too much. All right, anyways, let's get into the topics for today. We're going to be talking about Nick Cannon, who is, you know, expecting his 12th child has been announced. Chris Evans and Alba Baptista are dating officially. That's been announced. They've been spotted together, and it's been going on for quite some time. And it looks like Gisele has a new man in her life. It's a jiu-jitsu instructor. And that news came quick, so I feel like maybe that's been going on for a little bit. So, also, trivia. Game of Trivia, so look forward to that.
And Noah's back, officially.
Yep.
Yep.
Off suspension. And let's get into it, starting off with Nick Cannon.
I've talked all about my weekend in Vegas. It was tiring, also, as well. There's a time difference. You kind of forget about that. I thought Vegas was 2 hours. It's 3 hours. Yeah. So flying Thursday, getting there Thursday afternoon, having a show Thursday night. You know, the show starts at 8 o'clock, but it's really 11 o'clock. So I was really looking for that extra energy boost. I brought some of the proper wild energy shots with me, and they absolutely saved the day. Proper Wild is a clean all-day energy shot designed to boost your energy, focus, and productivity without the jitters or crash. So for me, getting there on Thursday, multiple shows, needed a little pick-me-up from time to time, and the all-day energy shots were perfect. No preservatives, no artificial sweeteners, no horrible chemicals, just a natural-tasting energy shot with clean ingredients that work. So there's this is the peach mango flavor that I have in my hand. There's also blackberry. It's very easy because they're small. So like I, you know, tossed a couple in my carry-on, went on my way, and they ended up being great and for sure helping me when I thought, oh, I would really love a nap right now. No. Had to power through, only, you know, spending 3 days in Vegas for the Jonas Brothers. As of this point, once. Maybe that'll change down the line. But you can go to properwild.com/barstool to try Proper Wild for 30% off. That's properwild.com/barstool.
We cannot keep up with this fertile man, Nick Cannon, who seems to be having a child every other week. A new baby's announced. He's on his 12th now, which was announced last week. And the 11th was announced the week before that. 2 different women. It's hard to keep up with.
It is really hard. You texted our group chat and you were like, Nick Cannon's having another baby. And I was like, different than the one we just heard about 5 days ago?
Right.
It's like, and it was like, yes.
Because when it's 5 days apart, you're thinking, oh, is it just recycled news? Yes. No. He, the 11th baby was announced because I think they just welcomed. I think she just had.
Yeah, baby's born.
Baby's
11th
born.
Baby 11th baby is born.
11th baby born. Yep. 12th one has been announced. Two different women.
Yeah. But I will say, and I don't very know if this confusing. Is on purpose. It does, I feel like he does have... It's almost, I don't.
Is it a sickness?
I no, yeah, maybe. I just. It's,
I actually saw a crazy.
It's like
theory.
A polyamorous situation, you know, because they are a lot of. Like, it's not 12 different women.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of repeats.
Yes, which does, it doesn't make sense though. He bounces from one to the other, yeah. Then back to the other, yeah. One, then back to this one, which I can't wrap my head around. Like, you, yeah. Have one with this one, then you have another one with that one. It's all over the place. I'm starting to think Nick Cannon has a sickness.
I think he probably does. He probably just has an obsession with
planting a seed. Or,
yeah.
The women want their babies to have the same father.
Did you see how much money he spends a year on his kids?
No.
He said over 3 million.
Maybe the women want their babies to have the same father, so when they want another baby, they call Nick Cannon up and they're like, all right, will you give me another one, because we already have one together and I want their sibling's, yeah. Father he to could, be the same dad.
And like, look, if he's a good dad and he's
how old is
what
the
hard
oldest?
To keep up with 12
no,
children with different baby moms.
How old's the oldest kid, do we know?
I think his oldest kids are his kids with Mariah Carey.
And hard to keep up for those kids to be like, yeah, I got a half sibling over here, half sibling over there.
He could literally have a basketball game, two teams playing against each other, and both teams have bench players.
Yeah. And subs.
It's insane.
So the baby that was just born is Beautiful Zeppelin Cannon.
The and first name's Beautiful?
Yeah.
I thought you were just saying she's,
yeah,
beautiful.
I was no. That's very nice.
First name is Beautiful. And this, he had this baby with Abby De La Rosa, who is, I believe, who he had his child, yeah. With when, unfortunately, that baby, yes. Had passed away really, really young. So that, she just gave birth, 11-11. That was, 11-11, that baby was born.
Make a wish.
That's a great birthday.
Mm-hmm.
So, Beautiful is born then, and now they have three children together. They had twins, Nick and Abby, Zion and Zillion, two twin boys in 2021.
Zion and Zillion, those names are way too close.
Yeah, that's tough for twins. You gotta like...
If I had twins, I'd name them Zach and Cody.
Zach. So I was
just to make it easy.
I was reading and was slow to laugh there. That is funny.
Just to make it easy.
Yeah, just to... So, yes, and then the... Oh, no, okay, so I'm wrong.
Wow.
Nick Cannon.
Just save that clip.
You know.
I'm
Nick,
wrong.
Nick Cannon and Alyssa Scott lost their baby to cancer, which is just insanely, insanely sad. That was, his name was Zen. That was at the end of 2021. Nick Cannon and Abby, who Beautiful was just born, mm-hmm. Have the twins that were born in 2021. And he has children with five other ladies. I was right on Mariah Carey, twins in 2011. Decent amount of twins.
He's got twins in his genes.
Yeah. Mariah Carey, 2011. And then since then, he's had children with five other ladies. Brittany Bell, Abby De La Rosa, Brie Tiasi. I feel like I always say her name wrong. She's the one that was with Johnny Manziel.
Mm-hmm.
Lanisha Cole and Alyssa Scott. And, okay, now I understand my confusion. Alyssa Scott.
My head's spinning right now.
Same.
It is really hard to follow. Nick Cannon and Alyssa Scott are having a baby. That is the 12th baby.
Yes. Do you think all these women have a group chat together? All the moms?
I don't know.
To keep track of their kids? You got to put them all in one place somehow.
I do think that they...
And Nick Cannon...
Think they have like a reunion?
Nick Cannon hosts the group chat.
That would be amazing to have all of them come together.
If I had to, if
what's
I had to
Thanksgiving
guess,
like?
If I had to guess, Mariah Carey is not involved.
Minus Mariah Carey, do the other women have a group chat with Nick Cannon?
Maybe. I do remember maybe an interview with someone saying that they like all do kind of get along. I could be making that up, which is they why I said it's like a polyamorous situation.
They have bi-weekly Nick Cannon Kids Club. Instead of a book club where they meet together and they just talk about their kids and catch up. Like, what do they do for Thanksgiving? Christmas. Nick Cannon's got to give so many Christmas gifts.
The thing
he's got to remember so many birthdays.
He does. He can't even... It's just impossible. You know how... Like, this is how my family does it, where you switch off holidays. So, you know, one year Christmas is my dad's side. The next year Christmas is my mom's side. And for him, it's like his kids, you get your dad at Christmas once every 12 years. Like, it's how do you go to multiple visits and multiple on the same day
Nick
as much
Cannon
as you can?
Is literally Santa. He has to stop at every single house on Christmas Eve night.
Dropping off presents.
And drop off presents.
Oh my God. So there was, Noah, what you were saying is there was a report from The Sun that came out that he pays nearly $3 million a year in child support. And Nick Cannon told the Neighborhood Talk that that number is actually much larger.
That doesn't surprise me at all. There's fucking 12 of them.
Yeah. He said, I definitely spend a lot more than that on my children annually. I don't plan to ever have to participate in the governmental system of child. So I guess maybe he has...
I think he has it figured it out with his woman.
He has it figured out with each lady.
Now, when do you think he stops? I say minimum 15.
No, I think he tried to hit 20.
Maximum 20.
Remember when he said he was going to go like celibate?
What?
Remember he said that? He was like, I'm done.
How old is he?
I think minimum 15.
42.
Oh, he's got plenty of time.
No, I know. I'm saying I think he has at least 15.
I think he goes maximum, till he's 60.
Maximum he has 20 kids. Bless you. Maximum 20 kids.
So we did talk about this, guys.
That'd be
February
awesome.
Of this year, he talked about his going on a celibacy journey.
The journey didn't last long.
After his eighth kid.
He had eight kids in February. It's been four more.
Wait. He had eight kids in February
more?
This year?
Yeah, I don't know what to tell you.
He's gotten to 12 in just the last few months. He went crazy after he said he was going to be celibate. Something hit him and he went nuts. He said, oh no, this life ain't for me. I got to pop him out as much as I can.
The thing is, you don't have to be celibate to not have kids.
I was just about to say something crazy and I stopped myself.
I'm not stopping you.
No, I just know that Fran would not want me to say it.
Earmuffs.
After spilling that he wrapped up his celibacy challenge around the end of 2021, Nick Cannon said, I just want to have as many children as that I can healthily provide for and be a good father to. This was in the beginning of February, and at that point he had just announced the arrival of his eighth child.
So he's had...
So this year...
Is that four more or five more? I can't do the math.
Imagine if the iPhone kept up with him like for new versions. Like
that's four more kids, right? Somebody answer me.
Yeah, eight plus four.
So. It's 12?
Yeah.
But the 12th child has not been born yet.
Okay, so...
I know, but if we're going how many kids born in a year...
He's had three kids since February. And he had eight in February.
9, 10, and 11.
So he's had like five just this year.
Wait, so when he said that, those kids were already on the way?
No, eight was on the way.
Eight was on the way. So he's had.
But he must have known.
He must have known about
the other ones, yeah.
Today, the Today Show put out a nice Nick Cannon's Kids Guide. Nick Cannon has welcomed 11 children with 6 women since 2011, with another on the way.
Well, good for you.
Mariah Carey. Mariah Carey is the mother of twins Monroe and Moroccan Scott. Born in 2011, they were married from 2008 to 2016. Yeah, that's also, let's also remember that, yes, those kids were born in 2011, but in the last 5 years, there's been so many because he was still married from 2008 to 2016. Brittany Bell, they share son Golden, daughter Powerful Queen, and son Rise Messiah. Lanisha Cole, they have a daughter Ice Cole Cannon with that baby was born in
Ice Cole.
September.
His first name's Ice Cole.
Ice Cole. It's O-N-X-Y Ice Cole is her
Onyx full, Ice Cole.
Yeah. September 2022. Abby De La Rosa, they like I just said, the twins, and then they just welcomed their baby.
Abby De La Rosa sounds like a fake name. Like a name in a TV show.
Yes. Alyssa Scott, they have their son that passed away. And they are expecting another child. And then there's Bree, who had son Legendary Love in June 2022.
The son's name is Legendary Love. So I'm assuming Nick Cannon's coming up with all these names because they are all out of the box.
Phenomenal names. They are really, there's a lot of,
wow,
a lot of funky names. So those are all the kids. And if I had to take a guess, this won't be the end. I saw everyone resharing a meme of, it was like, scientists predict what the human population will look like in 100 years or whatever the heck it is. And it was just like different variations of Nick Cannon's face, like, which is, you know,
not too far off.
He is taking on the responsibility of populating the next generation. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Nick Cannon.
And I don't think he's stopping anytime soon. If I had to take a guess.
I think you missed the conversation where me and Noah were taking a guess on how many.
Oh, you don't know. How many do you think?
We said minimum 15, maximum 20.
Yeah. Max is probably a good spot to stop it.
I would hope for 20.
Yeah.
20 is insane.
He's not. He's somewhere. He's over halfway there.
He would. Yeah. I mean, he did 5 alone this year, so.
He's putting the numbers.
Yeah.
It's a good point.
Just really putting up shots.
Yep. And scoring.
Yep. My favorite part about doing cutting stamps each week is the fact that we get to lay on a beautiful, comfortable Mattress Firm mattress that is big enough for all of us to lay on. And if you want a comfortable bed that's going to unjunk your sleep, look no further than Mattress Firm. We live in a land of junk sleep where people are waking up, oh, my back hurts, oh, my neck hurts, my legs. Nope, not with Mattress Firm. The way that they have you covered, finding a Mattress Firm that fits perfectly for you, perfect for your body, and a way that you will not wake up exhausted and feeling like you're just out of it. America needs real sleep. We need real sleep, the kind you get from a bed that actually matches you and your sleep preferences. Mattress Firm guarantees that we'll find the right bed for you at the right price with our low price guarantee, and they'll let you even try it for 120 nights to be sure. So say you're sleeping on it, you're like, this ain't cutting it for me. You could send it back and Mattress Firm has you covered. To unjunk your sleep, go to mattressfirm.com or a Mattress Firm store today and speak with a sleep expert. If you go to a store, you could test out beds, or you could just go online to mattressfirm.com and see which one you think works for you. Once again, go to mattressfirm.com or the store and talk to a sleep expert today. So Chris Evans revealed that him and Alba Baptista have been dating now for what it seems like around a year or a little over a year. And I thought that this was great news. Chris Evans has talked about how he's been wanting a lady in his life. And it seems like, you know, they've been.
The confirmation was photo evidence.
It was photo evidence. And then People magazine announced it. And then they were spotted out multiple times. And so I thought, cool, Chris Evans has a girlfriend. Didn't think anything of it. my God, has he upset some people. And I think it's so fucking ridiculous. Genuinely, it's one of those other, one of those things where when I say step outside, like people need to fucking step outside and get off their phones and get off the internet and like think they have, I can't wrap my head around it. Yeah. I did not know that this was a thing until I was looking at Dumois and I was like, what the fuck? People were writing like these submissions in long letters.
Chris Evans super fans.
But I just think a lot of super fans
think fair.
They are entitled to know everything about the person they're a fan of.
Yeah.
And never did Chris Evans sign off on everyone's allowed to know every single detail and has to know every single detail about my personal life. They're mad that he basically claimed he was single, or not claimed he was single, but just like presented the single man act, but had a girlfriend. I don't think that's crazy. I think maybe, you know, he wanted to keep that relationship private, see where it was going. And then once it was like a really serious thing, then it was like, okay, people can know about this. But I don't think there's anything wrong with keeping a relationship private until you feel like, okay, this is a serious thing. People can know about it. I don't really care. But like the fact that people feel so entitled that, oh my God, we thought he was single and he had a girlfriend this whole time. Well, was Chris Evans hitting you up? Because that's one thing. If Chris Evans was DMing you and pursuing you as if he was single, that's one thing. But if Chris Evans is just saying in interviews that he's single, that's a totally other thing. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it doesn't, I don't know. I just think, I just thought, cool, Chris Evans has a girlfriend. And I didn't know it was unlocking this tremendous hate towards Chris Evans.
It also wasn't news to us because, like you mentioned Dumas has been posting about Chris Evans and Alba for months, if not like the entire length of the estimated time they've been together. Like the articles are like, oh, they've estimated to have been around for a year, together for around a year. So it's definitely shocking for a lot of people, but we've seen these rumors for months, which is why when we were talking about Sexiest Man Alive, I was like, I'm pretty sure he's been dating someone or seeing someone. He said in the interview for Sexiest Man Alive, he was like, maybe I'm laser focused on finding a partner, you know, someone that you want to live with. So like he definitely alluded to wanting that. He didn't say I am doing it at that time. But like you said, it's not the first time that a celebrity has kept a relationship private while doing an interview. And if you want to say it's like lying, it's like,
I don't think it's lying. I think it's just private.
It's just not.
And people, you don't want to outright like, say, oh, I'm dating this person. And then the next, and then when the article comes out, you're not dating anymore. And then it's, you know what I mean?
I saw the argument. They were like, well, it was people's Sexiest Man Alive. Like he agreed to share about his life. He's got to share. Like you don't have to share everything. Now, do I think people would be a little upset that this happened like a week after instead of him just saying it in the interview? Sure. I'm sure they wish he talked about it then, but he didn't. And this is how it came out.
Maybe she didn't want, maybe she knows how the fans can be and was like, hey, let's just keep this private for now because people can get crazy.
Yeah, I would agree with you if there wasn't a picture of them like in Central Park holding hands.
Right, but that doesn't mean like people can still go out in public and not want to put it all over.
No, but I'm saying like if they really wanted to keep their relationship like totally private, they wouldn't be holding
hands.
Right.
I think it's more just like when it happens type of thing, not like we need to outright say it. You know what I'm saying? Like
they didn't say anything about it, but and yes, it's different to talk about it instead of just like living your life and being in a relationship and not speaking about it in interviews. But, you know, I would also imagine that at this point, if they have been together for a year, you want to be, if I was her, I'd want to be known. Not known, but like, I'd want to like move to the next level of my relationship.
Yeah, I mean, that's whatever. I don't care about their terms of their relationship. Yeah. I mean, I'm good for them. I don't, like, cool, they're dating. I thought that was my reaction. Oh, cool, Chris Evans has a girlfriend. Cool. But it seemed like people were so mad.
Yeah.
And I just didn't understand that.
Yeah, and, you know, she is an actress. I would say a little bit more unknown. She's 25, he's 41. Which, you know, people can have their opinions about. She is Portuguese. So she is very big. Like, she has starred in a bunch of Portuguese shows. And I think she has started to make her way more into international stuff. And now they are fully, I guess you could say, like, fully out in the open.
Well, you know what? Good for them. That's my take on it.
Yeah.
Happy for Chris and Alba.
You just, like, I feel like for so long now, Chris Evans has been talking about, wanting to settle down or find somebody. And so if he found it, that's great.
Yeah. This show is sponsored by BetterHelp. Unfortunately, our lives do not come with a user manual. So if something's not working for you, it's normal to feel like you're stuck. You feel like you can't just have it figured out. You don't know what to do. You don't know where to turn. You don't know who to talk to. That's where BetterHelp comes into play. Navigating any of life's challenges can make you feel unsure and stuck, like I mentioned, and you may not know what to do. But if you feel like you want to start talking to somebody and therapy has been on your brain for a while, but, you know, you're afraid of the money that it will cost, or if it covers your insurance, or, you know, just even going to an office or going to somebody in person feels uneasy to you, BetterHelp is the way to go. These therapists are trained to help you figure out the cause of challenging emotions and learn productive coping skills. BetterHelp is the world's largest therapy service and has matched 3 million people with professionally licensed and vetted therapists available 100% online. Plus, it's affordable. Just fill out a brief questionnaire to match with a therapist. If things aren't clicking, you can easily switch to a new therapist anytime, and it couldn't be simpler. So say you meet with somebody, you're not feeling it, boom, move on to the next one until you are feeling like it's right for you. And you don't need to see anybody in person. This can all be done over video chat, online, whatever feels the most comfortable for you. There's no waiting rooms. There's no waiting in your car, traffic, finding a spot, all these things that can lead to little stresses that then make you go, oh, I don't even want to go. Nope, just get right online and BetterHelp is there for you. You can learn more and save 10% off your first month at BetterHelp.com/office. That's BetterHelp.com/office.
It looks like Gisele Bündchen may have already found herself a new man. She was spotted in Costa Rica on a little dinner date, perhaps, with a jiu-jitsu instructor, Joaquim Valente. They were in, like I said, they were in Costa Rica. There were some paparazzi photos of them walking around. And that's kind of all the evidence of anything that we have.
You know, is he her jiu-jitsu instructor?
I don't know. I don't think so.
I feel like a jiu-jitsu instructor is...
Maybe, yes. How else will they have met?
I feel like that's perfect for her. I feel like she loves a fit man.
Yeah.
Yeah. But will he choose jiu-jitsu over her? Time will tell.
So, he has been... Joaquim and his brother have been learning jiu-jitsu from their father before they could walk, and now they teach at the Valente Brothers facility.
The Valente Brothers.
Yes.
It's a good name.
He began teaching classes in Miami in 1993. They have their family's full-time academy 5 years later. He was living in... their dad. Joaquim was still living in Brazil at the time, until he followed them to United States in 2007. Maybe they've known each other.
Brazil? I think they have known each other because there was something about living in Brazil. Something in February that she might have posted something, and they may have known each other through business. But I think that this is a quick move on from Tom, but I think that it was because she had been moved on for a while. The divorce may have just been finalized. But I think when that happens, that means that they have been apart for a while, and she has been moved on for a while, and they're both going to jump back into the dating scene. So why not? I mean, maybe Tom's going to focus more on football before he jumps back into the dating scene. But Gisele, she's going to get out there.
Yeah, I mean, he's got no room for love.
No, it's football.
It's football.
Football baby.
Season. In 2021, Joaquin and his brothers posed alongside Gisele for a Dust magazine spread. They were training.
Yeah.
Gisele had posted on Instagram as well earlier this year saying, like, thank you, Valente brothers, for being awesome teachers and making training so much fun. I'm looking forward to keep improving.
It's always the instructors.
Brady reacted via Twitter at the time, joking, my days of leaving dishes in the sink are numbered. She was training jiu-jitsu. So, yes, like, it could definitely be a romantic thing, but they could be friends, you know?
Yeah,
like,
they've
known each other for years now.
Right, and maybe he just sees this as his opening, yeah, and he invites Gisele to dinner,
yeah,
as a friend.
He could be a confidant.
Yeah, and then he sees his way to try and slip in.
Yeah, you're not, like, if I'm in his shoes, you're not just trying to take out Gisele for a friendly.
Yeah, you're like, oh, Tom, tell me about Tom. And then, like, are you seeing somebody? Yeah, are you interested?
Yeah.
Maybe he felt a little flirtation. Who knows?
Yep.
Anyways, I'm excited to see who they both date.
Yeah, exactly. I think, you know, when that split happened, there was a lot of, like, who could Gisele and Tom possibly date? And I do think, like, everyone was throwing around big names for Gisele. But something like this makes more sense to me. And I think I had said something like that, like, it's her time to be in the big seat. Like, I think she needs to, like, be the dominant
force.
Always,
she's always made more money than Tom Brady.
I know, but just public perception.
Speaking of people while dating, Emily Ratajkowski and Pete Davidson.
Yeah, there was a Dumas sighting, allegedly, that they were seen on a date in Brooklyn. The sightings are hard when there's no photos because it could just be completely made up. So we have absolutely no idea. Yeah. But she did post it. So.
And I think Emily Ratajkowski's dating around. Yeah. So I think she's been spotted on multiple dates, which I think is completely normal. Like, she's just casually dating multiple people. And I think Pete Davidson probably is like, why wouldn't I go on a casual date with Emily Ratajkowski? Why wouldn't we grab dinner and see what happens?
Right. The thing is like, people are like, oh my God. But honestly, so not shocking.
It's the least shocking thing ever.
Least shocking thing.
No, nobody seen with Pete Davidson will be shocking anymore after Kim Kardashian. It stopped at Kim Kardashian. Yeah. At this point, it could be anybody, and I'd go, yep, makes sense.
The only ones that I think that would get me would be, like, Martha Stewart. Like,
I was
like,
that's so weird. I was going to say Martha Stewart. Like, but that thing is,
somebody in that
we
realm.
Both thought Martha Stewart, and so that wouldn't be shocking.
Right, so it even,
what would,
like,
be most shocking is if Pete Davidson just started dating a normal ass girl that nobody knew.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, so if that sighting is real, I just feels like we all could have seen that one coming.
Right, it's not going to be the end all be all. Pete Davidson isn't going to be Emily Ratajkowski's new stepfather.
No.
Not hers, but her kids, but you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. It's interesting that they definitely have cut a lot of Pete out of Kardashians.
Yeah, like, he's talked about, but he's not in it.
Yeah, I was watching her try on the dress in Ripley's, and we all know from social media and, like, the other videos that he was there, and you can see, like, his feet. Like, he's there, he's sitting on the couch, but he's not actually in any of it, which is funny because he was totally there and participating and talking. And
yeah.
They must have just axed it.
Maybe he asked for that, or maybe they did it themselves.
Yeah, it's like, hey, at this point, the relationship is over. Why have everyone continue to talk about us?
Right, because then all the clips will be of them.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So that was probably a choice on their part. But, yeah, the next one will be who Tom steps out with, but probably won't be till the end of football season. It's time for another great game of Beat Rhea and Fran. But first, guys, Coors Light. Make sure you are taking some me time. It's the only beer out there that's made to chill. Fall does not have to be the end of your summer chill. Coors Light wants to help you find moments to unwind. So if you're watching college football games or you're going to Thanksgiving gatherings, you're just enjoying this time of year, you need time to turn off and hit reset. So for those moments when you need to just soak in the season, reach for a Coors Light. It's made to chill. We love Coors Light. It's mountain cold refreshment, made to chill, cold lager, cold filtered, cold packaged. Coors Light's the one we choose when we need to unwind. So when you want to hit reset, reach for the beer that's made to chill. Get Coors Light in the new look delivered straight to your door with Drizzly or Instacart by going to CoorsLight.com/chicks. And always, celebrate responsibly. It's coming from Coors Brewing Company in Golden, Colorado.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back with another game of Beat Rianne Fran. This is game 55, and we are joined by Amelia and Catherine, who we did meet at the Boston show last week, and now they are here ready to play trivia. Welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks for having us.
Yeah, excited to be here.
Noah clearly is affected by people who go up to him in person. So.
Well, it's harder to say no face to face.
Yeah, exactly. But
I feel you. I always say at live shows, if you send a picture of all of us, then I'll remember you and then we can get you on.
Right.
It's more like pop on my email. Like I see a picture. Oh, that's me.
We never said you were above bribing or any of
not
that
even
sort
a bribe
to get
this
on
is
the
just
show.
Like, oh, like we, yeah. Like Noah's, I told him in person.
Noah's head is getting bigger and bigger, I think.
What do you mean?
He's like, oh, there's me.
Well,
there's a picture of me.
It's just like it grabs my you're telling me that it's not going to grab your attention?
Right. No, it does.
Enjoy you having a semi-big head.
I don't have a big head. I really don't.
Whether you do or don't, I, whatever, you know?
For getting people on trivia, okay.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. Whatever.
Bribery works.
Yeah.
This isn't even a bribe. Like, what am I getting out of this?
No,
it's just...
No.
Yeah.
Any way to get on the show.
Yeah. I've never been bribed.
Yes, you have.
I think you have been. When we talked about it, I don't remember exactly when. But like I said,
people have offered you, like, tickets.
It's not that...
Oh, no, I've never taken them.
Oh, wow.
It's not that anybody's above it, though.
Yes, yeah. I meant more... Not that... You have, I don't know if you've taken any bribes, but
no,
the bribes have been sent.
They have been.
No.
All right, let's get into today's
also,
show.
Also, I'm back, thank you.
Yes, you are
yeah,
back.
Yeah, Noah's back.
Devin was
from
great.
From suspension.
Yes, Devin was great, and you were taken off suspension. Shout out to the girls who brought the take Noah off suspension sign. You were unsuspended that night because you hosted trivia at the show.
Yeah, well, we recorded Devin's before that, so.
Right, exactly. So now you're off suspension. How do you feel?
Good, like I fact-checked
all
the questions. No, because I fact-checked everything and...
Listen, I think we're ready to go.
Good.
Yeah.
Okay, ladies, it's going to be 15 rounds, 15 questions. If you get a question wrong, the other team can steal. To determine who is going to go first, Noah's going to give us a movie. We're going to guess the Rotten Tomatoes score, the critic score. Whoever is closest will get to go first. We will alternate guesses. So you guys can throw out a guess first, and then we will... After that. Noah, what is today's movie?
Today's movie is High School Musical 2.
Oh.
Shout out Kirsta for that suggestion.
High School Musical 2.
That's my favorite one.
Okay, so we're first.
One of you.
All right, yeah. I'm going to go lower. I'm going to go 36.
Feels like a nice ballpark range.
I'm going to go, I'm torn between two numbers right now. I'm going to go 48.
I'm going to go higher because I feel like this was the most successful of the three. So I'm going to go 79.
I think I'm going to go lower and say 31.
83.
Whoa.
What?
Wow.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yep.
High School Musical 2 has an 83%
it
credit
does.
Score.
You know what the first one has? 65.
What does the third one have?
Wow.
The third one has 64.
Wow.
The second one really is
the
most.
It's like the
High School Musical 2 is the most critically acclaimed High School Musical.
That's incredible. The best songs.
Wait, is Bet on it in second
yes.
one?
Yes. Oh my God.
That gets like 10% up right there.
What a cinematic sequence.
Yeah. And
that'll get me hyped
one
up.
Of the,
yeah.
One of the better ending songs, too.
That's just an amazing film, yeah. Top to bottom.
Yeah.
All right. So to Amelia and Catherine first.
Damn, so high.
Yeah. Okay. Question number one to Amelia and Catherine. Shout out Cassidy from Memphis. Matthew McConaughey is the face of what car brand?
Lincoln.
Lincoln, yeah.
Final answer?
Final answer.
Correct. All right. 1-0. Amelia and Catherine. Question number 2. To Rian Fran, shout out Kelly from New Jersey. What is the name of the girl band that Terry, Paige, and Ashley form in Degrassi?
No idea.
I can't remember. I haven't watched Degrassi in a decade at least. That's early.
You're throwing me off the way you guys are saying it.
Degrassi. Degrassi? No, he's saying Degrassi.
Yeah, it's fine.
Degrassi.
15 seconds.
I had no idea. No idea.
Nothing.
No, I haven't watched the ones with Terry in a long time. That's early, early.
All right. to Amelia and Catherine.
I don't even have a guess.
Okay. I've never seen it. So I don't have a guess.
I watched it, but like, yeah, 10, maybe even like 15 yeah. years ago, whenever it was out.
Do you have any guesses?
Like, just throw something out there. Like the starlets. This, I don't know.
Go for it. Good job.
Sure, the starlets.
Incorrect. It's PMS, which stands for Paige, Michael, Chuck, and the Sex Kittens. Mm. I'm glad that was a one that I was maybe going to use in the live show, and then I was like, I'm not sure how many people watched Degrassi.
I watched it, but it's so long ago. I don't.
Degrassi.
I also rewatched it.
Can't change.
Rewatched some episodes recently, but I don't know too much. I wouldn't know like Degrassi.
No, I don't think I would know Degrassi trivia.
Okay.
Great show though.
Yeah.
Great show. Yeah.
Okay. Still 1-0, Amelia and Catherine, and this is to them. Shout out Casty from Memphis again. What is Lisa Rinna's tagline in the most recent season of Real Housewives of Beverly Hills?
Neither of us watch Bravo. That's like this is our weak category. Okay. Lisa Rinna's tagline. That's like in the intro.
I don't have any guesses.
Yeah. Throw something out there.
10 seconds.
I feel like they're always like, I may be something, but I'll.
3 seconds.
That's you. Time. You got it.
I may be pretty, but I'll.
And
so I'll come at you.
Korean friend.
I have no idea.
I can't remember. And I watch every episode of Beverly Hills. But I skip through the taglines.
I don't know.
Because they're just not as good as they used to be. I don't even have a guess.
Nothing?
Nope.
It's, hi, I'm Karma, and yes, I am a bitch.
Classic.
I did know that. When you say it, it's like, yeah. Oh, yeah, I've heard it 9 million times, but.
All right. Yeah. Still 1-0, Amelia and Catherine. This is to Rian Fran. Shout out Lauren from Connecticut. What show or movie is the viral Adam Driver Good Soup TikTok sound from?
I have no, I didn't even, I don't think I even knew that's what it was from.
I don't even know what that is. Didn't he do a,
I'm just trying to think of Adam Driver movies.
Many Adam Driver
Star
movies.
Wars.
5 seconds.
What are some Adam Driver movies?
A Marriage Story?
Time is up.
It's dark.
We'll go with The Marriage Story. Final answer.
To Amelia and Catherine.
I was actually going to say A Marriage Story too, because that's the only one I could think of. Any thoughts, Kath?
I am terrible at celebrity names, so I can't even picture who this is. So I'm not very helpful.
10 seconds.
What was he been in recently?
5.
I don't know.
All right, time's up. It's Girls, the TV show.
Oh.
Girls. Yeah.
You know, did you say movies or TV show?
What show or movie? I said what show or movie. We'll rewind the tapes.
No. I'm just asking because my brain immediately heard movie.
What show or movie is the viral Adam Driver?
Oh, damn. I should have thought more about shows because I would have thought of Girls.
I would not have. I've never seen an episode of Girls.
Neither have I, but I know he's on it.
I watched.
I've heard it's good, but I just watched Girls. I can't stand Lena Dunham. Come on.
I did watch Girls. I didn't know that the good soup thing was even from him in that moment.
Now you do.
Yep.
Okay. Question number 5. And this is to Amelia and Catherine. They're up on nothing. Shout out Addie from Mass, who was at our Boston show. And I used some of her questions at the Boston show and didn't shout anyone out. Because during the live show, I just feel like there's too much going on where, like, I just want to read the question and...
I did see a girl get excited, though, about her question.
Okay.
You, so yeah, I think I used
multiple Addie from Mass questions. So thank you, Addie from Mass. And
thank you. We'll very much.
Sorry you didn't get credit at the live show.
Well, now she has credit now. Okay. Anyways, this question is, what artist does Bumper leave the treble makers for in Pitch Perfect?
Isn't it John Mayer?
I think you're right. Yeah. John Mayer.
Final answer?
Yeah. Final answer.
Correct.
I'm glad you guys knew that one. I'm dead. I remember
he like comes to the group.
Glad.
He's like,
I've
seen Pitch Perfect. I've seen Pitch Perfect one time.
Really?
Yeah.
Like we always get a lot. I feel like you loved that.
We get a lot of Pitch Perfect trivia, and I
feel like there's not that much. Maybe like.
No, that we've gotten a handful of questions.
Out of 55 games, I would say less than 4.
Yeah, I agree.
I think there might have been more.
All right, 2-0. Amelia and Catherine. This is question number 6 to Rhea and Fran. Shout out Jen from Delco. What is Jughead's younger sister's name on Riverdale?
Fuck. I didn't watch Riverdale. I feel useless today. I do like the variety of questions, though. It's all, you know, different, not the same old.
Yeah, well, I have 8 Harry Potter questions on to 10 seconds.
I mean, she's got like another one of those names.
3.
I never watched Riverdale. I have no idea.
All right, time.
Oh my God, I don't even have a guess.
Okay, to Amelia and Catherine.
Yuck.
Isn't it something like Ladybug?
Yeah, you're right. It's like something like that. Lady.
Yeah.
15 seconds.
I'll guess Ladybug.
That's my best guess. Yeah. Ladybug, final answer.
Incorrect.
She's close. It's Bug. It's Jelly Bug? Something Bug.
Jelly Bean.
Jelly Bean.
Jelly Bean.
Yeah. Bug made me think. I think it was the B word. I was like, something like that, and I was thinking J.
All right. It is still 2-0, Amelia and Catherine. And this question is to them. Shout out Caitlin from New Jersey. Throughout the series of Friends, Ross gets divorced 3 times. Name the 3 girls he divorces.
Oh. His first wife, which is Carol, I believe. The British lady. And then Rachel. What's the middle one's name? Kat.
I can't remember.
Carol.
10
Carol.
Seconds.
Rachel's the last one.
I'm gonna start with like an M.
3 seconds.
Oh, God.
Time is up.
Okay.
Korean friend.
Emily is her name, but it's
Carol, Emily, and Rachel. Yeah, they got married in Vegas.
Oh, yeah.
Carol, yeah. Emily, and Rachel.
Yeah.
Final answer.
Yes.
Correct.
Nice.
I love you, Emily.
Yeah, I have as reasons why Carol was a lesbian.
Yep. Correct.
Emily, Ross said Rachel's name at the altar during their wedding, and Rachel drunk in Vegas. Okay. 2-1, Amelia and Catherine. This is question number 8 to Rhea and Fran. Shout out Hannah B. from Atlanta.
did you just do that because of the bachelorette?
Yeah. She also specified in her email, I'm not Hannah Brown. So.
Very nice of her.
Yeah. Okay. Which Summer House cast member said the iconic line, "How many sandwiches have you made for me?"
Lindsay. That's our question.
Yeah.
Lindsay, final answer.
Correct. All right. Tied up. to all. Okay, question number 9 to Amelia and Catherine. Shout out Kirsta again. List the following pop, female pop singers in order from youngest to oldest. Ariana Grande, Dua Lipa, Rihanna, Camila Cabello.
Okay. Youngest to oldest?
Youngest to oldest.
Okay. Rihanna's the oldest. I think Ariana Grande is like our age, Kat.
Yeah, I feel like it's either Ariana or Dua
15 seconds.
Next. And then Camila's the youngest.
You think Camila's the youngest?
I would think so, yeah.
Okay.
But I'm not positive.
5
with you.
Seconds.
Maybe Camila, Ariana Grande, Dua, Rihanna?
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Okay. Final answer.
Incorrect.
I think Dua's the youngest.
Yeah, I think I would go Dua,
Camila, Ariana Grande, Rihanna.
Camila Cabello's younger than Ariana Grande?
I think so.
Okay, so Dua, Camila, Ariana Grande, and then Rihanna.
Yeah.
Final answer.
Incorrect.
It's Camila Cabello, 25.
Oh, she is the youngest.
Dua Lipa is 27. Ariana Grande is 29. Rihanna is 34.
So Camila and Dua swapped.
I know that Camila Cabello was 25.
Isn't Shawn Mendes like also like 25?
She's so young.
Yeah, I thought she was like, I thought she was like
28 or 29.
I thought she was like 26 and Dua was 25.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I really never thought about Camila Cabello's age before.
All right. Question number 10. I'm gonna play a clip from a movie and you tell me what movie it's from.
What have I said about knocking? Always knock.
Whoa, sorry, sir.
Now, what is so important that you need to interrupt me during my private reflection period?
Dodgeball.
Final answer.
Correct. Yeah.
All right.
That's a very distinct Ben Stiller character voice.
3-2, Rhea and Fran. This is question number 11. To Amelia and Catherine.
Nicknames.
Just gave you a little nickname there midway through the game.
I'll take it.
Okay.
Getting personal?
Yeah. Shout out Nicole from Mankato, Minnesota. What Pretty Little Liars actress was a guest star on Wizards of Waverly Place?
Ooh. I feel like
Ashley Benson.
Ashley Benson.
Yeah.
That'd be my guess. Okay.
Yeah. I'm good with that.
Yeah.
Right. Ashley Benson, final answer.
Incorrect.
Lucy Hale played one of his girlfriends. No?
I was just gonna guess Lucy Hale.
I think
because for some reason Lucy Hale, but I don't know what she played.
Why am I spacing on David Henry's character's name?
Justin.
I think she might have played one of Justin's. That could be wrong, but we're going to go with Lucy Hale.
Correct.
Did she play one of Justin's girlfriends?
I can look up her exact character.
Might be hard to figure out.
Who did Lucy Hale date? Or wait.
No.
She played Justin's girlfriend for 2 episodes.
Nice. Okay.
And she briefly dated David Henry in real life.
Oh, maybe that's why I remember.
Okay, 4-2, Rhea and Fran. This is question number 12 to them. Shout out Rebecca from Austin. What song do Katherine Heigl and James Marsden sing at the bar in 27 Dresses?
Benny and the Jets. Benny and the Jets. Benny and the Jets.
Final answer?
Yes.
Correct. 5-2.
She's got electric boobs. And he goes, boobs.
Great scene.
Something that maybe I don't know if you've
what?
Maybe like on TV.
You've never seen 27 Dresses? I've seen 27 Dresses probably 30 times.
I think I've just seen it like on TV, but like never. Ugh. You know.
Put that one up there with Sweet Home Alabama.
That I was on TV the other day. I took a nap during it.
Yeah.
I can hit one of the Benny notes in that song.
You can hit it.
Like
the high one.
The high one. Like
really. You can't say something like that.
No, no, I mean, I'm not going to do it now. Everyone in the office would be like, what just happened?
Okay, well, eventually we're going to have to see that for me.
Maybe eventually.
Yeah, you'll have
to. Get a couple drinks in me or something.
Yeah.
You will have to prove that at some point.
You want
to
come out this weekend? Yeah.
All right. Question number 13 to Amelia and Catherine. This is shout out Jill from Massachusetts. On season 5 of Real Housewives of New Jersey, what does Joe Gorga call Teresa that ignites the infamous Joe versus Joe brawl?
Never seen Real Housewives.
Heather Bravo. Yeah.
What does he call her? Obviously something like slut? I don't
know. A liar. I don't know.
Yeah. It causes a brawl. Cheater. I don't know. Did she cheat on him?
5 seconds.
What do you want to go with?
Slut? I don't know. I feel like that's like the most offensive.
Final answer. Yeah.
Incorrect.
Can you repeat the question?
On season 5 of Real Housewives of New Jersey, what does Joe Gorga call Teresa that ignites the infamous Joe versus Joe brawl?
I don't remember.
I don't remember either. Let's just go cunt.
Whoa.
Well, never mind then. I wanted to see the reaction.
Oh. Well, I'm just like, nah, I mean, I guess.
His sister. Yeah. That like what that would be
absurd. Yeah.
That would be absurd. That's what you ignited a brawl. What is something that would ignite a brawl?
We don't have an answer, so
that's my answer. But yeah. The way you reacted, you already told me that it's not real.
Yeah, incorrect. Scum.
Yeah. Scum. Yes. Yeah, scum. Yes, I remember that.
Joey's coming in later.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah. Never would have got that.
Big Joe will be in.
Okay. Still. 5-2 Rian Fran. So that actually seals the deal for you guys. But we'll do the last two questions. Shout out Hannah Brown again from Atlanta.
Is her name actually Hannah Brown?
It's just Hannah B. I don't know what her last name is. Okay. This is to Rian Fran. What was the title of the last album One Direction made as a group?
Boy, am I useless today. I don't think I know a single question.
I can't remember what our last one was. I just know I'm gonna go with Midnights.
I wasn't a One Direction fan, so I don't know.
Midnights.
Final answer. Incorrect.
Wasn't it four? Because four. It was the four of them. Okay. I don't know if that's a stupid guess, but that's all that's coming to mind.
Yeah, I have no idea. I'm thinking four.
Okay. Do you have any other guesses?
I was like, what was like their big hit song? But I think it was probably not on their last
History
album.
Was on that album. I don't know if Olivia was on that album. Yeah, but four is my best guess. Sure. Okay, four, final answer.
Incorrect. Made in the AM.
Made in the AM.
Is that Story of My Life on that? Or no, that's a different one?
I think that's a different album.
Okay. All right, final question. To Amelia and Catherine. Shout out Addie from Mass. What Taylor Swift song came to life in the New Girl episode she starred in?
Oh gosh. I don't think I saw that one. I only watched the early seasons.
Yeah, me too.
What Taylor Swift music video came to life?
What Taylor Swift song came to life?
Fairy Tale?
Good guess. I feel like it's off one of her earlier albums.
5 seconds.
Let's go with that.
Okay. Fairy Tale. Final answer.
Incorrect.
I don't remember this, but I feel like we should just go with like Love Story. Would make sense, maybe.
Love Story came from New Girl?
No. Taylor Swift, her song, like she was in an episode of New Girl.
Yeah. But the question is, what song
came to life?
Oh.
Like with the characters, I think, is what the question is asking.
5 seconds.
Love Story. Final answer.
Incorrect. Speak Now.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't remember that episode.
All right.
It was hard. The Degrassi one was something.
There were some tough ones.
Yeah, there were. Final
score. We had a strong
start. 5-2. Rian Fran, get the W.
Thank you.
Very nice. Thank you guys so much for playing.
Thank you. Yeah, that, there were some. There were some. Thank you. There were some tricky.
I
ones
liked
in there.
The variety of questions. Yeah. Though.
Yeah. There the were, double Bravo was tough for us.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I watched Bravo when I didn't know either of those.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, they're getting harder. Like the two-parter questions you've had recently make it really hard.
What was the two-parter here?
Not here, but like on, I think they're like a recent one, like the Nick Jonas one of like the diabetes and the song.
Yeah. People are getting... You know, or 55 games in, writing harder questions.
Mixed it up. I mean, a lot of games.
I mean, think about how many questions that is.
Yeah. It's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot of questions. So people are definitely getting creative.
Do you know your winning percentage?
I don't.
We should go back and figure that out, because I don't know how many games you've lost. Under 10, I
would say. Yeah, we used to really keep track of it, and then we just kind of lost track of it. But I think we're probably around 10. Losses.
I would say like around 10 would sound correct.
I don't know if we're under or over 10.
I would probably guess maybe.
We'll
like
have to go
9.
Back and look, because we really should keep track.
Yeah, we should.
Okay, ladies, thank you so much. Right. If you could send your sizes and address to Noah's email, we'd love to send you guys some merch for playing. And thanks for coming to the show. And it was nice to see you guys in Monica's. And hopefully we see you guys soon.
Yeah, thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
Bye, guys. Thank you.
Bye.
All right, that wraps up today's episode of Chicks in the Office. Make sure you are subscribing on YouTube. The YouTube episodes will be up early, so make sure you are looking forward to that. We love you guys, and we'll talk to you on Wednesday.